Joe is nonverbal. One of the overwhelming things about Joe is that he's very sensory seeking. So he's always looking for input. So he will do crazy things like walk on stones with no shoes. And he doesn't ever want to wear clothes because he likes the feeling of the air on his body. And clothes inhibit that. You can imagine wearing a big winter parka means you can't feel anything. So he would rather wear nothing.
How's school? Good.
He wants input of lots of different types of feelings, but then there might be a threshold at which, like, I don't want any more feeling. So you have to monitor that.
Oh, you made something at school today, an Easter egg.
I know him well enough to know, which is not necessarily a good thing, because really I need to force him to make him to want to tell me things. But he's got a PECS book and he can communicate a few things and he can do a little bit of sign language.
This is I want iPad. Do it again.
In 2015, Joe broke his collarbone in the playground, so we had to go by ambulance to A&E. We had x-rays and whatever, and then he was home for a week. But before he went back to school, I thought we'd better go and see the GP just to get the A-OK. And the GP's difficult for us. You make an appointment, it's difficult to make an appointment, and the waiting is very difficult for Joe. He doesn't know what he's waiting for. There's lots of people. And then sometimes the GP's a locum, and even though they've got all the information, they don't really recognize his condition. You know, that he is nonverbal, he's not aware of what's going on, he doesn't really understand what's happened to him or why he's there. So it was fine, and he was able to go straight back to school, but the whole experience is probably as traumatic for me as it is for him. I'm
Anne White. I'm a community paediatrician and I'm based in Brighton. And I'm academic lead for the Time for Autism program. This is a program to help medical students who will be our future doctors, our future healthcare force, understand more about autism, because it's a spectrum. There's a whole range of difficulties that children may have with autism. If they're visiting families, they'll see this spectrum. They'll appreciate the difficulties families have in that, you know, it's not just a diagnosis for the child, it's a diagnosis for the family. So the siblings affected, potentially, the parents are affected, potentially. And we want the students to learn to communicate with families, to learn to communicate with children who maybe have difficulties communicating. The families have all this knowledge and expertise that we can gather from them that will help our students. Make it easier for families to visit GP practices, visit hospitals, where in some cases they don't tend to go to the GP unless they really have to, because it's such a challenge. And going to the hospital may be a whole visit that needs planning out in detail to make it a success. So if we can make that any easier for these families, for the children, and for these children as they become adults, to attend hospital settings, healthcare settings, then that's got to be a benefit.
You can do it.
My experience with autism to date is mostly through my paediatric rotation. So I've sat in on a clinic with Dr. White. I think when you're in a clinic in a doctor's role, people are quite reluctant to tell you about how difficult their lives are, and they don't want to bombard a doctor with all their concerns and things and the day-to-day issues they have. So I think they probably don't reveal as much as they're going through. So I guess seeing the families in real life will give you knowledge that you wouldn't get from a clinic.
Nice work. Very good. Okay.
I think this programme will be helpful for families with children with autism because it gives them a voice. I think we need to be aware that parents are a huge asset to us and we need to take them seriously. They are experts in their children, and if you have a child with severe autism and they're non-verbal, potentially there's lots of health inequalities. And so I think this programme will help set the tone for other healthcare professionals in the NHS as well and kind of shape healthcare for children with autism in the future.
If you had no experience of what autism is, and then you saw it in real life, you'd be quite shocked. Because when I say that I can't get my child to put his shoes on, people think that I really haven't tried that hard. But when they see that it took three people to sit on him to get him to wear shoes because we were crossing a pavement that had glass on it. And I can't carry him. It's like, I'm not making it up. You have to see it. And then you get it. By having a real life experience with the family to see what happens, even if it's only for a few hours, can only benefit everyone, both their ability to be good clinicians and deal with families, and also for the likes of us, about more people having a greater understanding of what life's like on this side. Because it isn't terrible, but there are challenges, and also it's fantastic.
And frightened this mother away. Very good.